Can I say, first of all, how pleased I am to welcome Prime Minister Reinfeldt and President Barroso to London today. Prime Minister Reinfeldt, on the day before he takes over the presidency of the European Union, I believe that his presidency of the Council will mark major achievements over the next few months, and we have just been talking about some of the challenges ahead. And can I congratulate President Barroso on being nominated by the heads of government as their unanimous candidate to be president of the Commission. We have supported you throughout, and we continue to support your efforts as head of the Commission to take all the actions that are necessary to build a strong, fairer Europe. We've been looking ahead at the challenges that Europe faces over these next few months. The first is that we have to find a pathway to higher growth, to come out of recession, to create jobs, and to deliver sustainable growth. The second is to find a way forward to Copenhagen and to climate financing agreements that are necessary not just for us but for the developing world. And as you know, I put proposals on Friday, and I hope these will be part of a discussion that can lead to the July meeting that we're having under President Obama's chairmanship on climate finance, the September meeting of the G20 in Pittsburgh, and then to a successful outcome at Copenhagen. And we also talked about the security issues that face our continent and face the whole world. Europe must continue to stand for democracy and human rights. And so today we did discuss Iran. We are deeply disappointed that Iran has detained some of Britain's staff in Tehran. Some have been now released, but we must now see that the others are set free to resume their work. Iran's actions, first the expulsion of two diplomats, and now the arrest of a number of our locally engaged staff, is unacceptable, unjustified, and without foundation. And we, with our international partners, will continue to make this clear to the Iranian regime. Prime Minister Reinfeldt.
Yes, thank you very much. Since we are counting hours, I can say we are now 48 hours away from Swedish presidency. And of course, to be in London is a perfect preparation to meet with Prime Minister Brown and President Barroso. And we have, of course, talked about the incoming Swedish presidency, as Prime Minister Brown mentioned, very much on climate change and on financial crisis. I think with climate change, I welcome the speech of Prime Minister Brown this Friday. We need an initiative. We need to formulate a global answer. I think the political energy now building up so that we can get the conclusion later this autumn. It will, of course, very much be looking at financing measures, and we have been discussing them, and I think we will be engaged in talks about that all through the autumn. Then on financial crisis also, we will probably see in Europe a rise of unemployment this autumn, and unfortunately enough, probably coming years. I was myself at the job centre before coming to the Prime Minister, and looks very much like the efforts we are trying to see in Sweden to be active, to meet the rise of unemployment. But of course, it's very important to coordinate our answers in Europe, and especially this autumn on trying also to solve the financial crisis. So, thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Barroso.
Thank you very much. It was, in fact, an extremely good and constructive meeting, this one today. I'd like to thank Prime Minister Brown and also Prime Minister Reinfeldt. Today was also about discussing Swedish presidency ideas for the next 6 months. We will, of course, support fully the Swedish presidency and the work of Prime Minister Reinfeldt. Getting the economy back on track remains a top priority. I believe we are getting there. The G20 meeting in London, chaired by Gordon Brown, was a turning point. Avoiding a meltdown in the banking sector has saved thousands of jobs, but we also need to do all we can to give up hope to those who have lost jobs. I believe here we can and should do more also at European level. The single market is the backbone of the European economy and must be the cornerstone of our recovery. We need to preserve its integrity and see how it can deliver more. Part of our meeting today was discussing about climate change. How can we get an ambitious deal in Copenhagen? Both prime ministers have shown true leadership on this issue. We share exactly the same objective, the highest level ambition possible at Copenhagen in December. That means that we also have to decide on financing. And European unity will be decisive in making this deal happen. We have had a good discussion today on how to move forward, based also on the very interesting proposals put forward by Prime Minister Gordon Brown. We'll now work with the presidency and member states in the coming months to establish a strong and progressive European Union position on this important issue. having in mind precisely the meeting in the G8 in L'Aquila in Italy and G20 later in Pittsburgh. We are, of course, concerned with the Iran situation. I'd like to express my full solidarity with the United Kingdom. Intimidation and harassment are unacceptable, and they will be met with strong collective European Union response, as foreign ministers agreed. And I think we can say that this was a very strong United European position.
Thank you very much.